Whether you're an experienced geometry pro or just beginning to explore the geometry tool to create a new piece of Desmos art, learning the built-in transformation tools can open up new doors for creativity. We are starting here with a simple polygon. When we select an object in the graph space, an option appears in the top toolbar to transform. Within this menu are our four different transformation options: translate, reflect, dilate, and rotate. We will first use a translation to slide this polygon shape. We can define a translation by either clicking a starting point, an ending point, or a single vector. If we click one corner of our first shape as the starting point, we see an arrow or vector following the cursor until we click a second endpoint. Now, instead of using two points, let's see what using a vector can enable us to do. We will get rid of our first translation by selecting it and clicking delete on our keyboard, and then we will draw a separate vector object following that same path we just used. Now, when we create a new translation, instead of clicking two points, we can just click this vector object. But this is where the fun begins. Over in the token navigator box, which is located above the expression list, the gray tokens represent transformations we've performed. If we click and drag down this translation token, we see this translation as a function, taking any input represented by x and translating it across the vector. To add a bit of creativity, we can multiply this vector by a factor of 2, 3, or even a list of factors. As we adjust the vector, all the translations will echo that change. Before moving on to our next transformation, we will use the box select option to select all the objects on the screen and then press delete on the keyboard. After clicking the X icon by our function expression, we are back to our blank graph screen. Another transformation with lots of creative potential is a reflection. We will start with two lines, which will act as our mirrors that we will be reflecting over. First, we'll use the line tool to create a horizontal line, and then the perpendicular tool to create a line perpendicular to our horizontal line through a specific point on that line. From here, we will construct a couple of arcs in one of the quadrants of these lines. Now we want to perform our reflection on just the arc objects. We can hold down the Shift key as we click the arcs, so they are both selected. We have our familiar Transform menu option, but this time we will select Reflect. We are prompted to select a line of reflection, so let's start with the vertical line that we have constructed. Once our reflection is constructed, notice how we can adjust the initial points on our arcs and see those same adjustments being made on the new arcs. We can select all four of the arcs on our screen and click to reflect all of them over the horizontal line. This gives us an object stretching across all four quadrants, but all controlled by the adjustable points of the original arcs, so we can get the precise effect we may be looking for. For our next transformation, let's start with a new polygon. We'll be using a dilation, which takes an object and makes it enlarge or shrink by a certain scale factor. With my polygon selected, we can choose Dilate from the transformation menu, and we have two prompts. First, we need a center of dilation, which is the point from which our object will grow away from or shrink towards. We will click and place a point in the construction space. Next, we're prompted to enter a scale factor, which is the factor by which all of the lengths will be multiplied. By leaving this at 2, we will see our new object that is twice the size of our original object. If we click and drag the center point of dilation, we can see how the dilated image moves around the graph, with each vertex still 2 times the distance from the point as the original vertices. Like we saw with translations, let's go over to the token navigator and drag down this dilation transformation to see what else we can adjust. In the function definition, we can adjust this factor of 2 to a factor of 3, or down to 1/2 to make it dilate to half the original size. We can even add a list of values, increasing from 0.25 to 0.5 and continuing up to 2 for a fun growing effect. For our final transformation, we will be performing a rotation. Let's start now with a couple line segments and an arc connecting them, like the petal of a flower. We will select the segments and the arc, and again find Rotate in the transformation menu. Like in a dilation, we first select a center point, which is where my rotation will be spinning around. This can be a new point in your construction or an existing point. We will use the point connecting the line segments. Next, we need to enter an angle. We can simply type in a degree measurement, like 60, to see a rotation of that many degrees in the counterclockwise direction. Like with our other transformations, adjusting the points in the original object will have the same effect on the new rotated object. Let's restart that rotation now with a new strategy of determining the angle. We will rotate the same objects, still around the same center point, but notice how we also have the option to construct an angle. In Desmos geometry, you construct an angle by selecting three points, a point on one leg, the vertex, and then a point on the other leg. We will follow this pattern by clicking the point at the end of one of our segments, then the center vertex, and then the point at the end of the other segment. As indicated by the curved arrow now around the center point, the rotation is now following the directed angle that matches the angle between our segments. Lastly, let's drag our transformation token back down to the expression list and repeat that rotation a few times. We can see the angle icon in this transformation definition, and just like with a vector, we can multiply this angle by a scalar value. By adding a times 2, our object now rotates by twice the value of the angle. We can also multiply our angle by a list of values, 1, 2, all the way up to 8 times larger. We can then adjust those original points to end with just the right effect we were looking for. We can't wait to see what creativity you can show with these transformation tools.